Oké, welkom. We're in the final week of this weightlifting block. And we're gonna do the overhead press again. I got a different thing now, because Rob Simpson has programmed it so that I'm gonna do one rep five times, because this is pretty heavy for me. So I'm gonna do five singles. So thank you for that. I didn't see that at the beginning when I'm watching my program sheet, but 1 or 2 weeks ago I saw it. So I like that. I like that approach to do some singles in there, because it was heavy already. So I can focus more. I'm gonna try to do a strict press. If I cannot handle that, I just gonna use a little bit of leg drive. But again, I'm getting used to this bigger weight. I got the clip on the other side on there. So, the collar. Let's do this. A little bit of warming up. Not too crazy, some handstands and stuff. Let's see. One. Not gonna take long breaks. Just gonna do this after each other. Give me a couple of seconds. Drink my coffee. And then we proceed. And I need leg drive for this. Did I say how much it was? Well, you can read it in the description, but it's 72.5 kilo. So I could, if I'm in shape, could do this strict. I thought, I don't know for sure. I have to check that. I have to check my one rep maxes, but goal is to get eventually my own body weight, which is around 80 or so, doing strict presses. So, yeah. Heavy. I failed the first time. I sometimes forget that I have to get a little bit mad. It's a bit, if you are fired up, it's easier to do these type of lifts than you're relaxed. I'm a bit too relaxed. I had a very nice day at work. Maybe too nice. Now you have that if you have nice colleagues. So, William, thank you for that. But, yeah. It's also a mental thing. It's important. But, 3 to go. Two to go. It's a nice approach. This is, by the way, the first time that Rob has programmed a complete set of sets of singles after each other. So that is fun. It's good, I think, to do. Also with the 75, I also got singles on Thursday. Two more to go. I'm watching also my aquarium, because I'm cleaning it, and I'm gonna empty it for 3/4, and then I'm gonna fill it up again. I do that once every couple of weeks. Axolotls can be a little bit polluting. Shit a lot. So, if you don't know that, now you know. Axolotl facts. voortzet. Not my prettiest rep. Want to go. Still, the moment I get the weight totally in my hands, sometimes it feels very different. But with my last rep, it felt light, but I felt my first push. So I have sometimes that it feels heavy, and that it was going all right with the push out. It's funny. And it is, by the way, still raining. We have almost only rain every day for the whole week. Yesterday morning, by the way, had a little bit of dry weather, which I take, of course, to do some handstands. Come on, last rep in one go. Come on. So, that was it. I'm gonna do, by the way, some extra dumbbell overhead press next to it. Not gonna film that, but I do them standing. I saw that from, he was called Alpha Destiny. He has now, under his own name, Alex something. Leonidas, Alex Leonidas, if I'm right. But interesting guy if you want to know stuff about weightlifting, calisthenics, strength in general. Strong motherfucker. But he was doing with one hand on a post, doing dumbbell raises. And I like that, because you still need to use your body, you're not sitting still. And to do some unilateral work, maybe also interesting next to this stuff. With a lighter weight, more reps. So I got, I don't know, 11. Oh no, I got 10 on there and the weight of the dumbbell. So 11, 12, I don't know, something like that. Doing 20 reps, multiple sets. That's my accessory movement for now. Just starting this, so just kind of see and play with it. And yeah, you know, I don't know if it works. But if it works, I let you know. So, salute, and thank you for watching.